doesn't matter who asks the question. That's the last question that we have to go, okay? We have other obligations we have to attend to, all right? Respect the 10 minutes, please.
Deontay, what did you learn from the Fury fight?
The only thing I learned from the Fury fight is stay patient. You know, that was my moment. It was my time. You know, I had all the eyes and attention on me. It's hard in America. You know, when you're fighting against other sports, you know, boxing is not our most popular sport. So when you get that moment in time, you get that all eyes on you, you know, I wanted to do something that I always do, and that's put on a great show and knock them out. And I rush it. When I rush it, I know I don't get the job done. But like I told Fury, he had to be perfect for 12 minutes. I only have to be perfect for 2 seconds, and I displayed that.
Deontay, tell me about what you did today. I seen the video with Muhammad Ali. Tell us about that experience, how it came about with all the interruptions.
Well, you know, I got a call. You know, HBO was doing it, and they asked me would I be a part of it. And, you know, it was an honor for me because Muhammad Ali is one of my favorites, my idol. You know, so I was very honored to be able to be a part of that piece, in which I'm very passionate about what I say, I'm very passionate about what I do. So my passion about Muhammad Ali came out on the video, and it turned out to be one of the best that they had.
Where would you rank Brazil in your resume? Top 5, top 3?
Yeah, at the bottom. You don't belong in the ring with me. You don't belong in the ring with no elite athlete. When he got in the ring with one athlete, he got knocked out. And he's gonna do the same on Saturday night, get knocked out. But it's gonna be in a dramatic fashion.
Yeah, so we're not in this chapter, what's wrong?
You're gonna fight, Anthony Joshua's gonna fight, Tyson Fury's gonna fight. Does it frustrate you that you can't get your hands on him? Does it frustrate you that you're not fighting either Joshua or Fury?
No, it don't frustrate me at all. You know, especially with Fury, I understand. I gave Fury a concussion. And I made him lose a loss of memory. You know, if he felt like he beat me at a wide margin, it's easy. Why not rematch? But when you know you've been when you had a concussion and you lost a memory, he didn't even know how he got down the ground, nor did he get up. And that's bad for your health. So I understand him moving. With Joshua, I tried to fight him 5 times. Now that he has no option, he has nowhere to go. All of a sudden, it's smoke and mirrors. You know? But the thing about it, all parties are still talking, and the fight will happen. I just ask the fans to have patience, and we'll come patience come time. We'll see. But all the big fights happen in silence. Once they get amongst the media and everybody has an opinion to win. And this thing about patience, nobody wants to wait. The big fights that happen when it goes in silence and all the parties come together. And when it happens, you guys will know.
The Brazil chapter wants to fall on Saturday and put this behind you.
What's that?
Put this Brazil chapter behind
you. I can't wait. Like I said, he's like a fly in my ear. I can't wait. I'm gonna get him out of there. It's gonna be in a dramatic fashion. In a fashion no one has ever seen. His life is on the line for this fight, and I do mean his life.
Are you still trying to get that body on your record?
I'm still trying to get me a body on my record.
What's some of the favorite hip-hop artists you like to listen to when you're training? Hip-hop artists?
I like reggae. All types of reggae when I'm training, because you know reggae allows you to move.
Okay.
And in boxing you need the movement, you need the agility, you know, the feet work. So I love listening. I put my radio station Pandora on Bob Marley, and I just let it go.
Jim, while you're in Brooklyn, the Barclays Center's like your home away from home now. What do you think about the reception, and what do you think about fighting here?
Man, I enjoy coming to Brooklyn. You know, the people said they've adopted me. So when I come here, my Atlas name is the Bronx Bomber, but they say I'm the Bronx Bomber. So, you know, I welcome it with open arms. Look, I've had some of my most dramatic knockouts here, right here at Barclays, at the Barclays Center here in Brooklyn. So I'm looking forward to adding that more to my resume come Saturday night.
Would you have a preference of fighting Fury a second time or Joshua?
When it comes, you know. I want to get them both out of the way, so whatever order it comes. I'm sure you guys will be happy.
Absolutely. Yo, one more to come back, finish your move. You know,
ABAC ABB.
Are you gonna be disappointed if you don't knock him out quicker than Joshua?
I'm not gonna be disappointed. I'm not in a contest with none of these guys. You know, as long as I get the job, complete the task, complete the mission, and get the job done, I'm satisfied with that.
How do you feel when another fighter compliments you? Josh would just say that for this fight, that you have very, very fast hands, and usually when you go like this, fighters don't usually compliment each other. What do you say to that remark?
I mean, I appreciate it. You know, it takes a great person to you know compliment another one. You know, it's showing where the sport is going and the growth in fighters. You know, because everybody wants to be the man. Everybody wants to be the most famous, the most popular and stuff. And when you get another one compliment, that lets you know that they're growing in the sport.
What would it take when you go back to Vegas to fight?
What's that?
What would it take when you go back to Vegas to fight?
I mean, it's just the right time in the right place. You know what I mean? You know, it's a lot of places that that need to be tested in boxing. We're trying to make boxing grow all over the world, not just in the regular places that it usually comes here in Brooklyn, in Vegas, you know, in L.A. You know, we done in L.A. hasn't been done in a long time. So we're looking to make other we're looking to hit other states as well, too.
But you have Cowboy Stadium. I saw you when we talked.
Cowboy Stadium is on the radio as well, too.
Deontay, talk about compliments. I seen a video today. How impactful is that for you to talk to the kids, inspiration, speak and believe and receive it?
I mean, it's very powerful. You know, when I speak to the kids, you know, they always, when I came up, they said, we're the future. And, you know, they're the future as well, too. So if I can influence, if I can motivate a child to let them know that, hey, that's a possibility. Your words are powerful. Your mind is powerful. You speak and believe, receive it. The heart, the magic in the speak and believe, receive is the belief. If we don't believe we're going to go nowhere, we won't. We'll be a statistic in society. We'll believe our peers, what they say. Sometimes you have to separate yourself and have a strong mindset to say, I am going to do this. I shall. It's in the speaking that we speak. We have to speak in the present tense that it shall come to us, and we have to believe. Without belief, there's no faith. Without belief, there's no going. There's no tomorrow. Without belief, we can't be great. We all have greatness in us, but greatness is only determined by service. So apply your service, and you shall see your greatness about it yourself as well. Hey, Dominique Brazil asked for this. I didn't go seek him, he seeked me. So if it comes, it comes. This is a brutal sport. This is not a gentleman's sport. I keep saying this is not a gentleman's sport. We don't ask to hit each other in the face, but we does in a way. And you can ask any doctor around the world, and he'll tell you the head is not meant to be hit. Anybody can go. And on this particular time, we have bad blood against each other. This is the only sport where you can kill a man and get paid for it at the same time. It's legal. So why not use my right to do so?
You know, to this day, you became afraid of the people in this movement. Do you feel like you're a spokesperson now?
I'm just a person that's passionate about what I say. I'm passionate about what I do, you know? And that's it. A lot of people feel what I say. I'm the realest champion in the business. I keep it real with people as I want them to keep it real with me. And people clings to me on that, you know. I show love everywhere I go as I want them to show love to me. I'm a type of champion. I'm not bigger than no one, even no one in this room. Everyone sees me and put me on a platform. But I'm just me. I'm just Deontay. And that's how I want to be treated as I treat everyone else. Love is the key to the world. Love is the key to ending everything around us. If we show more love amongst ourselves, we'll see a better tomorrow. We'll see a better us. We're the strongest. We're strong people. We're all are strong people. Why is it so hard for us to love each other? It's not a hard thing. If we can invent technologies, the things to do things in a quicker or faster time, why can't we come together and stop this, the things that's going on, racism? We created it. We can end it. It's all about love, baby. I don't keep up with pound for pound lists. I don't really care about it. So, you know, I don't care about pound for pound lists. You know, I let those, you know, that those that care about it. I think that's a question for someone else, because I don't keep up with it at all. I don't care about that. You know, I just care about building my legacy and doing what I'm doing. I'm building for generation wealth. There will be one champion, one face, one name. And I'm looking at him.
You have to be a role model for others in this business, to be a businessman, not just a fighter.
Exactly.
You took that to another level.
Most definitely. That's why I'm betting on myself. Like I said, if I want generation wealth, I must take my career in my hand. I must do what's right. I don't want people to dictate my career. I dictate that, whether I go in the ring. I'm the talent, I'm the fighter. So with that being said, when you have the talent, and you know you have that talent to move to the next level, why not take control of yourself? Sometimes it can get scary because you don't have no direction. But I have a great team behind me, and they got they know what I'm looking for, and they're gonna get me all the way to the top. And I'm gonna be that living witness to show people that you can take control of your career and you can take yourself to the top and not let these promoters and managers make all this type of money off of you. When you're risking your life in the ring.
Last question. Being a heavyweight champion in America used to mean something. It used to be the biggest thing in sports. Do you feel like you're getting the respect you deserve from the American public? And do you think that will come in time?
All things come in time. You know what I mean? Like I said, it's the right time. At the right place. I think my career has bloomed at the right time and the right place. It took me 11 years to get here, but I've been marinating. Everyone can't be an overnight success. Everyone can't win a title at 19. Everyone can't be this big famous person. Look, I'm me. I'm a homebody. Everywhere I go, I have homes all over different states. And I'm at home. I'm a homebody, so I don't care about who knows me or what. All I care about is them kids. I have 7 children that I love dearly. And now, like I said, I'm building generation wealth. My father wasn't able to do it for me, nor his father was able to do it for him. But I can break the chain for mine, and I will. And that's all I care about. I don't care who knows me. You can ask the most famous person in the world, is it a blessing or a curse? And I guarantee you, it'll tell you it's a curse because they can't move. They can't go nowhere because people put people on high pedestals. If God came down right now, people wouldn't know what to do. But if someone touched someone like Michael Jackson's hand, they'll cry, fall down to their knees. And it shouldn't be that way around. It should be the opposite way around. So I don't care about who knows me or not. As long as I accomplish my goals and dreams, and when I die, my kids will be proud of me. That's all I care about.
Thank you.